PDAC 2018, we are now on the first day in the afternoon, and we are at the booth of Gold Mining. You remember the fantastic company assembling a really fantastic project together, really putting large resource together. And we want to talk now again with Chairman Amir Adnani for an update. Amir, welcome.
Thank you, Johan.
Yeah, great to have you here at your booth, and PDAC is fantastic. A lot of people, very busy today, right?
Always the same way at the PDAC. Super. This is the big mining conference, yes, of the year.
So let's dive into your fantastic company. Okay. You did a nice acquisition recently, right? Because we spoke in November last year at the Edelmetall Messe.
Yeah, we spoke in November. We've been very busy since then. Yep. We've made and have announced two additional acquisitions since then. Our first one into Peru. Yep. Now we're in our fifth country in the Americas. We've made additional acquisitions in Canada's Northwest Territories, mm-hmm, contiguous to our Yellowknife Gold project there. And so we've continued the theme and the strategy, Johan, of making these accretive acquisitions and putting ourselves in a position where, again, taking maximum advantage of the lukewarm market environment that we've had.
Yeah, and also I think you paid all the time, let's say, a price which was really worth doing it on the one hand, and on a, let's say, minimum dilution for the existing shareholders, but you got a maximum value out of that, right?
Correct. And the last deal, for example, we ended up issuing the sort of total value of the deal was $6 million.
Yeah.
Most of that was paid for in stock. $700,000 was in cash. Very minimal dilution. You know, we're talking about less than 4% dilution. Mm-hmm. But also, you're picking up resources in the ground. We're adding to our 43-101 resources, all at a significant discount to the replacement value of doing the work, doing, yeah, the drilling. But also now consolidating and now having a nice big project and land package in a part of Peru, in southeastern Peru, that's becoming of growing exploration interest by companies in the area. So again, we tend to be, in my opinion, always able to not only anticipate buying a good deal, but also anticipating that these areas will be of interest for development and exploration moving forward.
Absolutely.
Brazil's been that way for us. Colombia, yeah, has been that, yeah, way for us. U.S., Canada's been that way, and I think now Peru, and of course, Peru is an existing established mining jurisdiction, so
we're not
here talking about a new thing.
That's right.
But that's also what we like. We don't want to be in a country where we have to be the new guys or the new kid on the block. Yeah. No, we want to be existing mining law, mining code, everything is in good order, and then we get to come in and do the work that that we have planned. And speaking of which, in Peru, we've already issued our 43-101 resources. Mm-hmm. So this year in 2018, we've reported just about 1 million ounces of M&I resources, mm-hmm, at just over a gram per ton at the Crucero project, in addition to 1 million ounces of inferred resources also at a similar grade. So if you now look at our latest news release, we've reported that our global measured and indicated resources are at about just under 10 million ounces, mm-hmm, of gold only, and 11 million ounces in our global inferred resources.
Mm-hmm.
So the portfolio continues to get bigger.
Yeah.
Johan, this is all assets that we own 100%.
That's important.
So this is the important thing. Yeah. 100% ownership, zero debt, diversified, one of the largest gold resource portfolios anywhere
in the world.
In the Americas, anywhere in the world.
Yeah, that's right. If we put it all on the gold equivalent basis, what is it then, like 25 million ounces, or what is that?
We're starting to approach about 26 or 27 million,
exactly. Yeah.
Because there's about 2 billion pounds of copper resources associated with our gold copper porphyry projects in Alaska and in Colombia.
Yeah. I got also some questions from viewers which are following you guys, and the people were asking, like, yeah, why do you not start to develop São Jorge in Brazil into production? Because they see the gold price rising, they see a positive precious metal environment coming up. Honestly, I'm also seeing a much higher gold price. So they thought that they wanted to, that I asked you in the interview, actually, what are the plans on that?
I really, really like that project. I think it's probably the project that we have. We're talking about our San Jorge project in Pará State in Brazil.
Yeah.
We've had that project now since our acquisition of Brazilian Gold Corp in 2013.
Yeah.
It's a fantastic project. It's over 40,000 hectares.
Yeah.
Only 20% of the project has been discovered. Yet, on the 20% that has been explored, a very strong resource has been defined.
Yeah.
Work has been done in terms of metallurgy work, good recoveries of about 93% on the testing that was done. There was some work done on historic preliminary economic type work. So it's a fantastic project. I think anyone asking about that is asking the right question, because for us, if you say to me, tomorrow we're going to have a higher gold price and the opportunity cost to make more acquisitions goes away, and that now you're focused on development, I think San Jorge will be the very first project that we could advance towards production. I just think right now we're still in that period where, yes, the gold price has improved, but you know very well that the gold stocks are lagging.
Oh, yes.
Not just shares of gold mining, but gold stocks in general are maybe 40% lower today than they were in 2016 when we had the same gold price.
Yep.
And so there's clearly a dislocation here. Perhaps the gold price is leading the gold equities higher. And for us, we're kind of continuing to look at it saying, look, we are doing inexpensive work right now. We don't want to do expensive. Expensive work is drilling. Inexpensive work is improving economics, doing permitting, doing geology, modeling the work that was done already, doing very interesting deals. Like recently, we had a 4% royalty on our Cachoeira project. We bought 3% of that down now.
Yeah.
Now that project has a much better path for future development. So you look at the work gold mining is doing, there's one thing we don't like. We don't like unnecessary dilution. See, if we dilute...
Oh, wasting money.
That's it. Yeah. So we're running a very tight ship because insiders own 25% of the company. We have a strong treasury. We don't like dilution. If there's going to be dilution, it has to be for an asset coming in.
Yes.
Where the value increase is greater than the rate of dilution.
And you know what I call it?
That's
positive dilution.
The positive dilution. There you go. I like that. I'll start using that.
Yeah.
Well, I think that another term for positive dilution is accretion. So, you know, if you're doing accretive acquisitions, that's the idea behind that. So, look, I think it's very smart. The people are inquiring about San Jorge because they see, just as we do,
that they
this is a development ready kind of asset.
And
it's got incredible profile.
Fantastic. So maybe one more word on resources, reserves, etc. I think you improved overall also a lot.
We've continued, you know, it's amazing. I mean, I think I've got my very first interview with you, we may have had 1 or 2 million ounces of gold resources.
Yeah.
And you're talking about over 6 years now.
That was November 2012 on the Edelmetall Museum Munich.
That's
it. I looked it up.
November 2012. 12. And we owned 1.2 million ounces.
Yes.
With our Cachoeira project.
Yeah.
And today, just in measured and indicated, we have just under 10 million ounces global and 11 million ounces in global inferred. From 2012, that's execution.
That's
putting our money where our mouth
beautiful
is.
Beautiful development, I would say.
That's it. So I think, you know, I come to these conferences and I talk to our shareholders and I say, look, we said what our strategy is. We're executing on that strategy. You can watch my interviews with Johan and look at how every interview from the first one in 2012 to this one, we continue to execute the model. Now, the market will sometimes cooperate, sometimes it won't. But ultimately, as long as we're building the intrinsic value and executing on the business, doing it with a good balance sheet and positive dilution, right? Look, I think we're extremely well positioned for the coming bull market in gold.
Absolutely.
And I'm really looking forward to that. And also believe with our team, your audience can't see, but there's a very strong team of representatives from gold mining here, and we've built a very strong nucleus that understands how to permit projects, how to build projects, and some of our key shareholders, as you know, who are very important to have. You know, today on our holders list, we have IM Gold, Centerra Gold, we have Brazil Invest, we have Sprott Asset Management. We have some very strong shareholders in
understanding
gold mining
the business also.
That are from the business.
And understand what you do.
And understand what we do. They're from the business. And that's a strong vote of confidence in what we're doing.
Definitely. I think you strengthened also the team itself, right? You put some more experts on. Maybe you can comment on that.
Well, as the portfolio keeps getting bigger, the level of expertise needs to expand and go deeper as well. And I'm really proud of this because recently we've really significantly added to our depth of our technical team. We've added some of the world-leading experts in the areas of gold-copper porphyry and epithermal gold deposits to our team. Dr. Jeremy Richards, Dr. Ross Sherlock, Dr. Mike Roberts. Mm-hmm. We've added to our management team with the addition of Jeff Wright, who has 22 years of mining, investment banking, and analyst experience. He was involved in 100 transactions, value aggregation of $2.5 billion. So we've added really meaningfully to the depth of the technical team, to the depth of the management team, to enable a greater bandwidth of the kind of corporate things that we, actions that we have, capital market strategies that we have, acquisition and development strategies that we have. So yes, I think that's important for shareholders to appreciate as well, that again, we're paying attention to the needs from a human resource side of things that need to improve as you keep growing a portfolio as we have been doing.
Fantastic. Amir, thank you very much on that. And thank you're doing the right things. The only thing what is missing, higher gold price.
And that'll come.
that's what we need.
It's important because that's not an if question, that's a when question.
Exactly.
And we all like questions that start with when, not if.
Exactly. That's super. Right. Amir, thank you very much.
Keep it going. Thank you.
Great. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, that was Amir Adnani, the chairman of Gold Mining. And you heard it. I think the company is doing everything right. And as you heard, positive dilution is key for the success for gold mining. And they are preserving well their cash. They are paying with shares. But it always has to be, let's say, secured that they make much more intrinsic value than they are paying on the dilution. And so you heard it. 10 million ounces M&I, 11 million ounces inferred, and altogether approximately 26 to 27 million ounces gold equivalent. I think that's a great statement for the future. And as said, the only missing thing is a higher gold price, and this company will skyrocket. Check it out. Thanks for watching us. Bye-bye from Toronto.